Kubernetes is one of the most popular tools for managing containers and container-based applications. It can help you easily manage even a large and complex infrastructure for applications that are running inside containers. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a local Kubernetes cluster using Minikube. Minikube is a tool that makes it easy to create a local Kubernetes cluster. I don't recommend using Minikube to build a production Kubernetes environment, but it's great to get that local Kubernetes environment up and running for development and experimentation. A production Kubernetes cluster usually has multiple servers or nodes, which are used to run your actual containers. But with Minikube, we just want a simple, easy local environment. We don't need multiple servers. So what Minikube does is it allows us to create that compact single node Kubernetes cluster quickly and easily. Minikube simplifies the process of creating these local clusters by running inside of a container itself or inside a virtual machine if you choose. So before we get started, these are the four basic steps that we're going to be going through in order to set up our local Kubernetes cluster with Minikube. First, we're going to install a container runtime so that we can run Minikube itself inside of a container. And I'll be using Podman for that purpose, but you can use other tools like Docker or even a virtualization tool like VirtualBox. Then we're going to install kubectl. That's a command line tool that we can use to interact with our Kubernetes cluster once it's up and running. After that, we'll go ahead and install Minikube. And then finally, we'll use Minikube to create our local Kubernetes cluster. So let's go ahead and jump in to our demonstration. So for this demo, I'm going to be using a basic Ubuntu 20.04 server. And my first step here is going to be to install Podman, which is going to be used as the container runtime to run Minikube. So for my first command, I'm just going to put dot and then a space followed by /etc/os-release. And what that's going to do is just load some version information for the current operating system into some environment variables so that I can reference those in some of these commands that I'm going to do. Next, I'll go ahead and add the kubic repositories to my server here. So I'm basically just going to add this line, and that's referencing this environment variable with some information about our current operating system version. So I'm gonna add this line to my sources list. So essentially that will add that package repository to the list so that I can use it to install Podman here in a moment. And I also need to add the GPG key for that repository. So I'm just gonna download the GPG key here and then pass it to sudo apt-key add. So now I have my package repository set up and I'm going to do a sudo apt-get update to update my package listings. And Podman does recommend that I do an upgrade as well. So I'll do sudo apt-get-y upgrade. Now that the upgrade is complete, I'm ready to go ahead and install Podman. So I'll do sudo apt-get-y install on the Podman package. And now I just need to make sure that my user has sudoers access to interact with Podman. So I'll do sudo vi sudo, edit my sudoers file, and I'm going to come down here just to the end of the file. Doesn't really matter where I add this, but I'm just going to do it at the end. And I'm going to add sudoers access to cloud user because that's my username. So there's my username there. And I'm basically going to allow this user to access /bin/podman. So I'm just giving my user sudo access to use the Podman executable there. So I'll go ahead and save and exit that file. Now that I have Podman installed and configured, I'm ready to move on to the next step, which is to install kubectl. That's going to be our tool that we'll use to interact with the Kubernetes cluster right here from the command line. So first, I'm going to go ahead and just download the kubectl binary. And then I'll install the binary. I'll give it the root user, as well as the root group, permissions 0755. And we're just going to install that kubectl executable in user local bin kubectl. So now I should be able to test kubectl. So I'm just going to do kubectl version, which is going to list the version information for kubectl. So I did successfully get my client version, but at this point, I'm going to get this message here when kubectl tries to get the version information for the Kubernetes cluster itself. And that's because we haven't actually created our cluster yet. But so far, we do have kubectl working, and we're ready to go ahead and install Minikube. So I'll just use curl to download the Minikube executable. And then I'll just do sudo install to go ahead and install that executable. And I'm going to install it in user local bin. And I'll just call it Minikube. And now all I need to do in order to create my Kubernetes cluster is just run the Minikube start command. And this will take a little time to complete, but once it's done, we should have a working Kubernetes cluster. So now Minikube start is finished running, and I should be able to run kubectl version and see both my client and server information. So there's my client version information, and there's the server version, which is coming from my Kubernetes cluster. So I am able to communicate with my cluster using kubectl. That means I've successfully built a local Kubernetes cluster using Minikube.
So that's it. We've successfully built a simple, easy local Kubernetes environment for development and experimentation. You can interact with your Kubernetes cluster however you like, use it to run your container-based applications, or even build something new. You can even create additional local Kubernetes clusters if you want separate environments for different projects. Check out the official Minikube website or the Kubernetes documentation to learn more about what you can do with these great technologies. If you want to dive deeper into Kubernetes with a Cloud Guru, you might want to check out our Introduction to Kubernetes course. That's a great place to get started. I've added some links for you to find these documents alongside other useful resources, including a couple of free EKS and GKE courses currently available on a Cloud Guru. But for now, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have questions or comments, add them below. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for watching. Keep being awesome. We'll see you next time.